Ken, this is Janice and Ford. We are here to talk about inflammation today. Going back to our previous videos, we talked about insulin resistance and cholesterol. I'm going to start out by asking Ford, I've gone to my internist or family medicine doc many times, and I've never heard inflammation mentioned. What is inflammation, and why don't we hear about it?
Well, actually, to go back to inflammation, you might need to use a military term. Have you ever heard the term friendly fire, taking friendly fire in a battle?
Yes.
And that's where you're getting shot by your own somebody that's supposed to be on your own side, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly what inflammation is in this sense. Our immune system is actually causing the damage. It's doing that by trying to clean up LDL, or bad cholesterol, which has been deposited in the artery wall.
Okay, and so through our own practice, we do labs for inflammation or inflammatory markers.
Right.
Can you describe a few of those in detail and what they mean in terms of inflammation?
I sure can. So, you know, when I mentioned that the immune system is actually causing the damage, here's how it does it. The immune system's doing what it's supposed to do. It finds LDL in the artery wall, and it goes in and it sends immune cells in. These immune cells release enzymes. Those enzymes dissolve that LDL so the body can absorb it. But here's where the problem is. Those enzymes and some of the other chemicals involved in this process, if those enzymes touch blood, they form a clot. So if that hot plaque or that inflamed plaque comes back out, leaks back out of the artery wall and into the blood, it forms a clot. If the clot's big enough and it goes to the heart, it's a heart attack. If it's big enough and it goes to the brain, it's a stroke.
Okay. Just for further definition, you mentioned hot plaque.
Mm-hmm.
Can you describe the difference so we all know what you're talking about?
Well, normal plaque is a waxy substance, just like it's a waxy substance. After those immune cells start releasing these enzymes, then it becomes liquid.
Uh-huh.
And if that liquid comes back in, we talked about it, it can form a clot. Now, you asked me about markers. It just so happens that two of the markers for this process are those enzymes. MPO, or myeloperoxidase, and LPPLA2, which we just call plaque2. Those are both enzymes that are released by the immune system to dissolve this LDL. There are a couple of other markers that we look at as well. Well, one of them is CRP, C-reactive protein. There are more and more docs that are beginning to understand the role of inflammation in this process. Now, usually if you find a doc who does think about inflammation in terms of heart attack and stroke, they usually just look at CRP. That's a protein that's made by the liver as a reaction to any type of inflammation. And it's not very specific. That's why we look at more than just CRP. Some docs just look at CRP and think they know enough information. Here's the problem with CRP. There's too many false positives. If we had 100 people...
Which, again, let me stop you right there. False positive.
So you could get a positive CRP test. And it may not mean any heart related inflammation. It could be something else.
Okay.
So where I was going to say, if we gave 100 people a flu shot today,
okay,
2 days from now, 66 of them will have an elevated CRP. They don't have heart disease, but it's just another form of inflammation.
Okay.
Which the flu shot is programmed to stimulate.
Okay. Well, I think that's it for this video.
Not quite. There's one other test that we look at, and it's the most important test in my book. It's looking at the microalbumin creatinine ratio.
Okay.
Now, it isn't the amount of LDL that causes that deposit in the artery walls. It's whether or not the intima, the lining of the artery walls, has been burned. And usually it gets burnt and irritated or inflamed by high glucose. Okay. Other things can as well, but the major focus is high glucose or prediabetes. Now, when you look at microalbumin creatinine ratio, here's what you're looking at. You're looking at albumin, which is the most common protein in the urine, or in the serum, and you're looking at it in the urine. The microalbumin creatinine ratio is a urine test. So if you are spilling protein in your urine, then it's coming through the filter in your kidneys. Guess what that filter membrane is? It's the intima, that lining of the artery wall. So if you're spilling protein through that lining of the artery wall, that means the artery wall is irritated and inflamed throughout your arterial system. That is a critical thing for us to know in terms of heart attack and stroke risk.
Okay. So how would patients out or people out here listening to this, what could they carry forward to their own internist or family medicine doc? What kind of questions should they ask?
It's a very simple thing. And in fact, these days in all the states that I know, you can even get your own lab tests. And CHL, Cleveland Heart Labs, which is part of Quest, has an inflammatory panel, a cardiovascular inflammation panel. You can just go to a nearby Quest and get that test for yourself. Take it to your doc and see how he reacts. You can also come to us. This is the purpose of this whole channel, is to help people understand a little bit more about the key risk factors for heart attack and stroke. If you want to get deeper in terms of working with us, you can email Michelle, myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you hit the like button, and for sure if you subscribe or share, the algorithm reads that as a strong message that humans think this is interesting and important information. And the algorithm can share it more than any of us humans. Speaking of sharing, one of the best ways of sharing is on social media. We've got active Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn activities going on right now. We've recently started up things in Pinterest and Twitter, so we'd love to see you there. Check us out. Finally, with over 500 videos, a lot of people are saying, I can't find this video or that video. Our new social media manager, Kim Hermosa, is starting to work on ways to help with that. So join the community. You can click on the links below and you can get a little bit better access. Thank you again for your interest.